Time now for another Bite with Butch. Butch, I hear this week's kind of a big game. You kind of know this team pretty well, UM. I know it's been circled on everyone's calendars. You say it's just another game, but there is a little history there.
Sure.
And just kind of curious what it means to you to be back coaching in Miami. I know what you did against them when you were at North Carolina, sure. But to be back coaching in Miami against Miami.
I know it sounds like coach speak, but to be honest with you, I mean, until this week, I mean, we paid no attention to Miami. I mean, we had way too many games, the first three games opening the season against the Big Ten Indiana team and going on the road against the team at ODU that beat us at home last year. So, you know, we've had to focus week by week. It's a young football team, and we're just, you know, our goal obviously is to get better every single week. Obviously, now we've gotten into the Miami week, you get a chance to watch their film. They're very, very talented. They've got a lot of explosive players at skill positions on offense. Their defensive line is probably the best that we've played against, certainly at least through a year and a half. And they're a really good football team.
I was going to ask you what you thought maybe their toughest aspect would be going against. And you mentioned the defensive line. But this week against UMass, you had two 100-yard rushers. You guys ran the ball very well on the ground. What did you like out of Sean Darius, especially filling in for a guy like Anthony?
Well, first, I think that Sean has gotten significantly better as a runner. I think his vision, he's starting to, once the kids learn the offense and they understand that sometimes it's patience when you get to the line of scrimmage so that holes open up and you have vision and stuff and that you're not just trying to cram, you know, the ball carrier into a certain gap, you know, and now it's being patient, seeing where the holes are. You know, we already talked about Miami's defensive line. They've got two excellent returning inside linebackers that have been starting for them their entire career, and they've got three seniors in the secondary. So this is going to be a real challenge with a good defense.
Now, I know you got to feel proud of this kid, Maurice Alexander, making the position change and then seeing what he did, not only in the receiving game, but in kick returning last week. Can you just talk about the strides he's made as an athlete?
Well, he's made a ton. And, you know, first thing is, obviously, it's very, very unselfish when you see a quarterback that says, hey, look, I think I can help the football team. I'd like to move this position. And then obviously week by week, you can see the impact that he's having by making that move. You know, he's a dynamic athlete, and his contribution certainly on special teams last week is something that, you know, we take a little bit of pride in, that we would like for that to be something that, you know, is good every single week, because you're trying to find guys on the team specific roles. What do they do best? And what can they do to really truly give you a chance to win the game?
Yeah, now I noticed today at practice, and like at many practices, you got the crowd noise pumping in. Right. Hard Rock Stadium's going to be rocking just because of the proximities of these two schools, the number of alumni in this city. Right. How amped up are the players for Saturday?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I mean, I hope they're not amped up at all, to be honest with you. And right now it's focusing about getting prepared for the game. Obviously, emotions and adrenaline and all that stuff will come, you know, on Saturday afternoon. The crowd will be loud. And, you know, all you want, and we do it every time we play a road game and stuff, is try to have as much noise distraction as possible so that it forces your team to have to communicate either hand signaling wise and or verbally, because you can't just go on the assumption that guys can yell and tell you what's going on. You got to be able to do things, and they focus on their assignments. Last year we started doing that, and I think the kids like it.
Okay, we'll see how they handle it. Kickoff between Miami and FIU, 3:30, Hard Rock Stadium. Coach, as always, thank you.
Thank you, appreciate it.